During the contest, I wasted a lot of time manually assembling the VM code. For the sake of this write-up's beauty though, I'll use FASM's preprocessor to do this work for us. First of all, let's define some instruction macros. For example, this add macro means that from now on, if the assembler sees an add with 3 parameters, it won't issue an x86 add instruction, but instead it will do whatever is in between these brackets, namely writing a 1, the add opcode, followed by its operands. All the other instructions are implemented in the same manner. We would also like to implement some label functionality. FASM already has that, but it uses byte offsets for labels. This is normal for x86. The problem with that is that this VM addresses memory at a DWORD level, basically every 4 bytes, not every byte. To work around this, we can make this macro called label that takes in a name and sets the preprocessor variable with that name, i.e. our label, to the current address, denoted by the dollar sign, divided by 4. Just as a precaution, I'll add a check that we still are 4 byte aligned, as I might, for example, declare a character and offset everything after that by a fourth of a field, which would render the program useless. This isn't so much label related as it is to just alarm us if we did something wrong. I'll also define the syscall numbers so that we can use their names instead of constantly looking them up. Let's test it. Here's the program we first tried. It begins with the offset to the entry of the program. After that, we have a label called A, which just is the number 13. After this, we have a label called B, which is the number 37. After this, we have the label sum, which is where the sum will be put. And after that, we have the two constants 0 and 4 used to exit the program. Finally, we have the label called label entry, which is where the code starts. We have the add instruction, which adds A to B and puts it in sum. And then we have the subtract instruction that just exits the program. Sending it to the server, we can see that it works just as well as the first one. Over here in the third position, we have the sum of 13 and 37. But this is much more readable and way easier to change as the manually assembled code we had earlier. To make it even better, I wrote this simple Python function that takes in an assembly language string, adds the macros before it, writes it all to a file, compiles that, and then returns the compiled VM machine code. This means we don't even have to compile it manually. Neat. Now we have all the knowledge and tooling required to actually write the proxy. See you in the next video.